Hey there, folks. Today's topic is out of the world. Quite literally. There is a whisper in the cosmos, a tantalizing possibility, alien life. But before we break out the party hats, let's dive deep into what Dr. Nikku Madhusudhan, an Indian astrophysicist and professor of astrophysics and exoplanetary science at Cambridge, found on distant planet K2-18b. It was a Monday night, though it didn't really need to be even night for Dr. Nikku to look at the stars as he was using the JWST, which is placed at L2 point, far from earthly attachments or problems like daylight, clouds and others. He was looking into an area that has some peculiar planets. So what's the buzz all about? Well, it all started with a remarkable discovery made using the Kepler Space Telescope during its second mission phase. The celestial body of interest orbits a star roughly the size of our Sun. That star, a red dwarf, also known as an M-type star, the most common type in our galaxy. Red dwarfs, like our star system's nearest neighbor, Proxima Centauri, often plays host to thrilling celestial tales. In fact, approximately 80% of M-type stars are expected to have planets within their habitable zone, regions where liquid water could exist. Some even harbor entire systems like TRAPPIST-1 with its 7 terrestrial planets. Intriguing, isn't it? However, life around red dwarfs poses unique challenges. The stars emit plenty of infrared radiation, but comparatively little visible light. This lack of visible light makes it uncertain if complex life like photosynthetic organism could thrive. In essence, the stars might not be the best hosts for life as we know it. It will require certain types of light that many of the stars simply cannot provide. And so, chances of fully synthetic life here would be extremely low, almost impossible. But in this case, the K2-18 star is a little bit more massive than a typical red dwarf. And so it does produce a little bit more optical light. But the other problem with this type of stars is that they are also very active. They produce huge amounts of flares and can actually strip the planet of all of its atmosphere in just a few million years. But this star might be a little bit less active and is currently considered to be a little bit more mild. It's a bit different from the typical red dwarf planet. It orbits its parent star at a distance, completing one orbit every 33 days. But there is also another planet in the system, much closer, with an 8-day orbit. K2-18b, however, resides right in the habitable zone. But here's where things get intriguing. Initially, K2-18b didn't seem overly exciting. However, in 2019, additional observations, including those from Hubble, hinted at something remarkable – water. At first, it wasn't clear in what form, but the consensus began leaning towards a liquid ocean. The catch? This planet is hefty – at least 8.6 times Earth's mass. A world with a liquid ocean of such magnitude is a novel concept. Further examinations unveiled another layer of complexity. Observations indicated the presence of significant hydrogen. This suggests the planet might have a hydrogen-rich atmosphere, somewhat akin to a gas giant. It gave birth to a novel idea, a hyacinth planet, a unique hybrid of water world and a gas giant. But what turned K2-18b from intriguing to astonishing? The discovery of dimethyl sulfide, or DMS. Now, this gas may sound toxic, and indeed it is. It was considered for a gas attack during World War I. But here's the catch. DMS has only one known natural source on Earth, the ocean, produced by marine life, particularly phytoplankton. This is where it gets mind-blowing. If DMS is exclusive to phytoplankton on Earth and is detected on K218b, there are several possible scenarios. It could be a mistake, a quirk of alien chemistry, or brace yourself, extraterrestrial phytoplankton. Let's not jump to the conclusions yet. The discovery might be an error, or there could be unknown chemical processes at play in the unique condition of high-seen worlds. The truth may lie somewhere in between. Confirming these findings will take years, and we might never be entirely certain, but the mere possibility of extraterrestrial life on a distant exoplanet is exhilarating. It reminds us of the boundless mysteries our universe holds. So, what's the verdict? Celebrate cautiously. While we wait for answers, let's embrace the wonder of scientific exploration and the finite possibilities that lie beyond our blue planet. As we journey into the cosmos, remember to stay curious, stay wonderful. If you are as captivated by the cosmos as we are, don't forget to subscribe and share this video with your fellow space enthusiasts.